Hey everybody, this is Eric from Valve, and today we're talking about the updated bulk pricing tool. This tool makes it easy to manage prices for your games across all currencies, even if you have a big catalog. It also makes it easy to see at a glance if there are any potential mistakes in the prices that you've entered. All right, let's jump right in and check it out.
Before we dive into the bulk pricing tool, let's talk about how pricing works on Steam. Steam supports 39 different currencies so that it's easy for customers to shop for games from the biggest markets around the world. As a developer or publisher, you set the price of your game on Steam in every currency. You can choose any price you like, with the exception of some rules around maximum pricing and minimum pricing. To help manage pricing in those 39 currencies, Steam offers recommended pricing conversions based on the US dollar price you select. So, what is recommended pricing? We know it can be challenging for game developers and publishers to be familiar enough with each region in the world to know how best to price their game in each currency. It's a hard thing to do. So, we've established a set of reasonable pricing recommendations for every currency based on a few important factors. One is the exchange rate adjusted for local purchasing power and standard of living in a region. Next is taxes, whether they are inclusive or additive. You can choose to use the recommended pricing conversions that we give you, or you can override any or all of them with your own price points. It's been a while since we last adjusted the recommended pricing. In that time, currencies have fluctuated quite a bit. Recently, we've updated our recommended pricing. Developers and publishers set their own prices, so feel free to embrace or ignore the recommended pricing as you see fit. We provide recommended pricing conversion as a service to help you sell your game in 39 different currencies. At a high level, price changes on Steam follow a very basic pattern. First, you can select from a list of pricing tiers to use price conversion recommendations, or you can manually enter the price of your game in all currencies. Next, you'll save your pricing changes and submit them for review. When we review the pricing you've submitted, we're looking for obvious pricing errors, such as a decimal point entered by mistake that makes the game much cheaper or more expensive than you intended. If we find a potential issue, we'll reject the pricing so that you have a chance to re-enter it. The bulk pricing tool now helps you tell at a glance if there are potential errors in the prices you've entered, but ultimately, as a developer, you control the price of your game. Once Valve has reviewed your price changes, you'll get a notification that the prices are ready for publishing. Finally, it's time to publish your price changes. Those changes will only be visible to customers once they've been published. Let's dive into the details of the new pricing tool and I'll show you how to use it. Okay, here's how to find your way to the new pricing tool. Just select Apps and Packages and scroll down to Pricing New, and that will take you here. And the first thing that you should know how to do on the new pricing tool is filter down to find the game on your list that you're looking for. In this case, I want to change pricing on Day of Defeat, so I'm going to select here and type in Day of, and that will filter down directly to Day of Defeat. And this is helpful because you can find not just one particular game or package. You can also find multiple games in a series or a franchise just using the same name. Of course, it's really easy to remove a filter at any time. You can just select this button here, and we're back to our view of all of the various packages that we can change pricing on. So next, to change price, also really simple. You're just going to go over to Day of Defeat here and select anything here from our list of suggested pricing tiers. Right now we're $4.99, but if we wanted to go down to $3.99, for instance, you would just select $3.99. And you're going to immediately see that there are some blue boxes that appeared here and also some tooltips. And those tooltips are telling us that the entered price is, in this case for Chinese yuan, 18% lower than the currently saved price. That's cool. That's probably what I intended by lowering my price. And at any time, I can discard changes by just going down here and selecting discard. It's saying, are you sure you want to do that? And I say yes. Now we're back to where we were. Another way that you can change pricing is by manually entering in a number. And you might want to do this if you have a special price in mind that isn't in the suggested tiers of pricing. For example, if we wanted to price this at $4.79, not 4 cents, $4.79. And you can immediately see that unlike changing a price using one of the pre-existing pricing tiers, it didn't automatically change and update the pricing for all of the other various currencies for this. And that's because I have entered in a custom price. Now, if I wanted to use those recommended prices for other currencies, I can click here and it will show me the recommended price, and I can just select that really easily. And you can see that that's down 4% from the currently saved price. Or I can use recommended prices, and recommended prices will automatically change all of the pricing for various currencies to the recommended prices, but it will do that to all visible packages. And that means to any package that is currently visible on our list here. Now, I don't want to do that because I don't actually want to change pricing for all of these packages. I want to just do it for Day of Defeat. So if I want to do that, I would just filter back down to Day of Defeat, and then I could select recommended prices and apply to visible packages. Now that I've done that, you can see that all of these currencies have been adjusted and reflect the new recommended pricing that we have for you. And of course, any of these can be changed back to the published price, or you can select these fields and change it however you like by keying in a number. Okay, before we move on to the next step, I want to talk a little bit about another feature of the new pricing tool, and that's that it gives you real-time feedback on the pricing that you've entered. For example, with the euro price, we are going to intentionally miskey the price and just make it a fraction of what it used to be. And what you're going to see here is a couple different errors are going to pop up. One is that it's telling us that it's 90% lower than the currently saved price, so that might give you an indication that something is a bit different. Also, there's a red box and this other, you know, exclamation point has appeared, and that's telling me that the price is below the pricing floor on Steam and it needs to be adjusted. Another example is we made the price very, very high. Let's say that we accidentally added a 9 there. You're going to see another pop-up here telling you that the entered price is much higher than the recommended price based on your US dollar price. And of course, we're 1,224% increase than the currently saved price. So these indicators here tell you in real time when you may have made a mistake on the pricing that you've entered. It makes it really easy to tell at a glance that there are any issues with your pricing. I don't actually want to submit this pricing, so I'm going to go ahead and discard changes, and we're going to go back to the pricing that we had entered earlier. Okay, now that we've entered our pricing, the next step is submitting our prices. So to do that, we're going to scroll down here to the bottom, and you can see that we have 42 pending changes, and then just hit preview and save. Now, when you submit pricing, you have two choices. You can publish new pricing immediately after it's reviewed, or wait until I manually publish. If you choose to publish immediately after review, the new pricing will naturally be live as soon as the pricing is reviewed by Valve. If you choose to wait, then you can come back and publish it yourself when you're ready. In this case, I will select I want to manually publish these change after review just so I can show you what that step looks like. So I'm going to select this and hit save. Okay, and now the price is in review. And you can tell that, of course, because there's a handy little note here under price status. Of course, I don't actually want to change the price of Day of Defeat, so I'm not going to show you the next step, but essentially, once the price has been reviewed, you could return here back at the pricing tool, and you would see an option here to select to publish the price. There's a handy tip to quickly find all the packages with pricing that's submitted for review, and you can do that by navigating up to this drop-down menu and selecting Show Packages Submitted for Review, and that will narrow those down for you. Okay, that covers the basics of updating your pricing, but I wanted to cover a few important notes. If you've scheduled the discount less than a month out and you try to increase the price, it simply won't publish. However, you can save your price change for review and wait until after the discount runs to publish it. Also, remember, if you raise your price in any currency, you can't discount your game for a month. So it's usually best to update pricing after you've run a discount when it's already on cooldown. Okay, we're back here on the pricing tool home screen here to cover the last few options. First, we already covered recommended prices. Just the thing to keep in mind here is that When you hit apply to visible packages, that will apply to all packages that are currently here, visible and not filtered out. The next menu option is import-export CSV. If you click on this, you can download a CSV that contains pricing for all of the packages that you have currently visible, or you can import a CSV. So once you've downloaded a CSV with all of your pricing, you could make changes to that, and then you could upload it. And by uploading it, you would stage changes in the pricing tool. And when you import your CSV, it will also populate the recommended pricing conversions for you. And of course, you can adjust anything that you like. And finally, don't forget to save and submit whenever you make a pricing change. If you have any questions or feedback about the bulk pricing tool, you can reach our biz and tech teams directly in the link below.
Okay, that's pretty much everything you need to know about the updated bulk pricing tool. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll catch you in the next video.